improvement. And you know what? You get better at playing tennis by playing matches. And I think we can really see the success. What do you think, Chuck? You've been out there a lot. You've seen a lot of improvement, right?
Absolutely. I think it's a good idea to have the practices during the week and then the practice, the match play, and put it all together. This is a really good program, Janet.
Yeah, I think it's fantastic. And Zena, where'd she go? There she is. I'm sorry. This is Zena Garrison. As you know, we're going to have a big prize today that includes Zena having a private clinic with Zena. Also, a dartfish analysis. Scott Thornton was here before. He has all that special video stuff that can actually see it down to a second when you're hitting that ball, if it's hitting it late or whatever. So I'm going to let Zena talk in a little bit, but I want to go over about the future, because every parent has been coming up to me and they said, just hold your horses. Let me get it all out. What we were doing this fall was really a preparatory to playing the official junior team tennis. We were playing kind of the official matches with doubles and all that, but you have to understand, now we form teams. And those teams will compete against each other here in the Baltimore County Championships. And that's going to be starting in January. So just to go over it for everybody so you understand what it's about, is that you have to have a minimum of 3 boys and 3 girls on the team, okay? We can have up to 10 kids on the team, which is nice to have a couple of extra kids in case somebody's sick or whatever. But the requirement is you're going to have to be a USTA junior team, a USTA member. All right, you have to be a member because these scores are actually going to go on the USTA website. Now, this year they've changed something. If we actually progress, the teams that win here will progress to something called states. We've already gone to sectionals, and it's my dream. Just like, remember the Southeast Learning Center? They went to nationals this year in Arizona. I'm hoping this year we're going to get a team to go to nationals, Miss Garrison, okay? I think we can do it. But let me explain something. Do you all know what USTA points are?
Yeah.
Okay, you're going to start earning points if you go to states. And what they've changed this year is that if you were, there's two types of players on these teams. There's something called an intermediate player, and there's an advanced player. Now, advanced players, you have to have 350 more USTA points. That's a lot to have. There's some kids, I look around the room, that might have that. They would have to play advanced. But everybody else would be intermediate, which is fine. It's fine. It's just two different sections. The other thing is, when we play official USTA junior team tennis, there's only certain age categories. We're going to be doing 10 and under. Victoria's going to talk about that in a minute. That will be the quick start format. And let me tell you something. I was so disappointed when I went to sectionals in Virginia. Here were all these quick start kids in Greenspring, had nobody there. So I really want to take teams there to state sectionals, okay, for quick start. Now, another thing is that in junior team tennis, it goes 10 and unders, which is quick start. 12 and unders will be the full-size court, 14 and unders. Now listen, 14 and unders, and then it jumps to 18 and unders. There is no 16. Today I'm giving an award for 16, but that's not really junior team. I just wanted to get as many kids out to get some awards, okay? But it's 18s and unders. So if you're 14 until what the birth date has to be August 1st, right? Soon as, if you're turning 15 before August 1st, then you have to play 18s. Does that make sense? Anybody have a question so far? Parents, are you following me? Now you're saying to me, well, Janet, when are these practices going to be? That's going to be the next question, right? And I want to thank all the parents here today and all the kids because, you know what, getting this all together with this amount of kids, it's always hard to find the right time in the days. So I really appreciate it with some of the pros and everything that sometimes we had in the morning, sometimes we're just working it out. But it kind of all came together. We all got our matches, so I really appreciate your support in that, okay? So this is how it's going to shake out. I don't know, how many of you seen my website lately? Oh, you're the best. You should be checking the website. That's where I put all your pictures and stuff. We have a video on there with our two high-performance coaches, Matt Towns and Joey Addis, and they're duking it out because they're recruiting for their advanced team, and that's going to play on Friday afternoons. And Vicky's going to talk about, she's going to probably be doing her quick start, I think, on Friday afternoons. Other than that, I see so many kids. We're probably going to keep for the intermediate plays. Whatever we build up is Sunday afternoon. Okay? So I think it seems to be pretty good. What's your thoughts on that? Pretty good? Yeah, I think Sundays are pretty good. All right, we have a lot of awards and a lot of things to do. So what I'm going to do first is bring Vicky over.